Hello, and welcome to episode 7 of Let's Play Civilization 6. We last left off with our unexpected war against the Brazilians, but now that we have a chance, might as well go for it. So I'm just going to try to get an army together to attack Rio. I don't know how hard it's going to be. This will be my first real war against the AI. I don't think the AI itself is going to be hard to beat, but in terms of the mechanics, how the encampments here work, how long it takes to siege a city, will be interesting. So we'll see. I think I want to get. Okay, I think I want to get a couple of cannons. And more muskets as cannon fodder because my archers really can't take a lot of beating. As you can see, this is down to half health just from one volley. So let's see here, what else can I produce? Okay, 16 turns here, 4 turns here. We'll let the turns tick away for now. Pull this guy back here. That's not good. I left my general exposed. It's the only unit I have to spare. Or maybe not. Nope. Well, that's not good. Okay, I can't move this guy here. Okay, well, hopefully that the AI doesn't kill our general here. Oh, Chinese didn't like our. Yeah, they thought we were a warmonger. Well, we kind of knew that going in, that the war penalty was really huge. Well, the die is cast, as they say. Pretty good volley there. Gotcha. I upgrade my archers to field cannons. That makes a lot of sense. Okay. This makes more sense. I'm gonna move this guy here. That's gonna make it interesting because I now have a lot more field cannons than I thought I had. Turn here. So I see there's two bars. I guess the blue bar is the defense, and then once I knock that down, I have to work through the health bar, which does tend to slow down sieges a bit more if we're going by Civ 5 mechanics. Will be interesting. I mean, there's a whole debate going on about. Oh, I was waiting. Here I am waiting for the next turn, but. Okay, I'm gonna pull him back here. Yeah, there's a whole debate going on about one unit per tile versus stacking. I like both, really. I mean, one of my favorite games, well, both, more than one, two of my favorite games, Civ 3s and 4 are pretty good, and they're stacking games. But Civ 5, which I also like quite a bit, is one unit per turn, and they have advantages and disadvantages. It's not like. I don't know what he's talking about. I guess he's talking about these units, so I'm not attacking him, I'm attacking. Yeah, I'm attacking the Brazilians. So yeah, I mean, they both have their own advantages. I don't really have, you know, have a oh. I don't really have a preference. Although, I mean, what we have now in Civ 6 is one unit, and we've had that for a while now since Civ 5. So I think some people can't let it go. Like they're like really attached to the stacks from Civ 1 through 4, and you know, they go on the forums and they like complain about it, even though we've known for months that it's going to be at one unit per tile. It's just a little bit funny. Okay, let's heal that up.
The best steel doesn't always shine the brightest.
Okay, can I do here? Let me sleep that unit here.
There were seven wonders in the world, and the discovery of the Terracotta Army, we may say, is the eighth miracle of the world.
Okay, I got my industrialization boost from that. What do we want to do? Oh, I was doing Forbidden City. Let's finish that. I want to build some more militia. Pulling him back. Oh, let me upgrade that. Keep that route going. Thank you. Okay, what do I want to do here? Yeah, this ship has been parked here for a long time, and there used to be warnings when your city is in range of things like this. Not sure why I'm not getting it, or unless it moved out of sight and then just moved in this turn. It's a little bit weird. Oh, they already have infantry, which is interesting. I think I need to move my units in. Okay. 8 turns, okay. So let me buy another trade route, or trader unit. I like having all this gold. Oh, I can build a military engineer as well that helps me build roads, okay. Let me build the trader first, and then I'll get the engineer next turn. Muskets going. Counter a spy, okay, so I can place. I know that someone's been stealing stuff from Washington, so. And all Jews in district from enemy spies. Do we get all of these to go with this? Okay, I guess I do. Send that to St. Louis.
Claims that cannot be tested, assertions immune to disproof, are veridically worthless whatever value they may have in inspiring us or exciting our sense of wonder.
Nice that they got a Carl Sagan quote in there. What's the sanitation? I didn't break the promise, I was attacking someone else. I don't really agree with that.
A great engineer has
Okay. How many turns do we have left? I'll save him for now. I might lose this unit here. Okay, let's get another musket out. Granary. Yes, we want to keep the city. It's weird. So they... Is this your new capital city? Oh, it is your new capital. So they're willing to give up this city. Let's take it. Thank you. Okay. Well, ends our first war. I think this is a good place to end, but we've gained two cities. We got Rio and Curitiba. I really wanted the city because it's kind of on the north edge of Charleston, but it's turned out to be their capital, so ended up not taking it. I might just declare war on them again later and take it, because I know the world already hates me. What else do I lose? I'm down that path. So, yeah. So get some walls going here. Get more trade routes going. Let's rest up a minute here. Okay. Let's look at our score. All right, thank you very much for watching. I will see you next time.